Various groups and opposition figures commemorate the 30th anniversary of the civilian-backed military revolt that ousted the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. They warned the legacy of the historic event could be erased by ongoing efforts to amend the country's constitution. We have this report.
Buhay ang EDSA!
With linked arms and clad in yellow, opposition leaders and personalities gathered at the EDSA Shrine Friday morning to attend a mass and participate in a rally, which are part of the activities to mark the 1986 People Power Revolution. Among them are Senator Risa Ontiveros, Albay First District Representative Edsel Lagman, former Senators Leila De Lima and Bam Aquino, and Attorney Chel Diokno. They also issued a call against the ongoing initiatives to amend the 1987 Constitution. Joining them were members of Buhayang EDSA Campaign Network, a coalition of people's organizations, academics, political parties, sectoral formations, and non-government organizations. Many of the participants wore yellow ribbons and carried yellow flowers. For the coalition, coming together in defense of freedoms, which Filipinos fought for 38 years ago, keeps the spirit of EDSA alive. Commemorating the 1986 People Power Revolution aims to remind those in authority that people will not stay silent against those who seek to perpetuate themselves in power.
Hindi pwede na wala na yung ang diwan ng EDSA. Nandyan pa ho at palalakasin ho natin lagi yan sa pananawagan natin ng katinuan sa pamahalaan, kaayusan sa pamahalaan.
We can never underestimate the value of prayer. God should always be in the equation whenever we fight for justice, human rights, protection of the poor.
Apart from concerns that amending the charter could weaken the constitutionally guaranteed safeguards to people's rights, Ontiveros and Diokno believe the initiative could also be part of efforts to erase the legacy of the 1986 EDSA People Power, which toppled the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
All of those come together, yung pagtanggal sa pamana ng EDSA, yung pagtanggal sa anibersaryo ng People Power Revolution bilang opisyal na holiday. And yes, itong chacha dahil ang 1987 Constitution ay bunga ng EDSA People Power Revolution.
Marami na rin mga galaw sa edukasyon para sabihin nila na golden age nga yung time na yun. Samantalang alam naman natin na hindi. At itong pagbabago ng konstitusyon, parang gusto na rin nilang makalimutan yung nangyari at kung bakit tayo nagtayo ng 1987 Constitution.
The President and the leaders of both houses of Congress gave assurances they are only interested in amending the restrictive economic provisions of the charter to attract more foreign investments into the country. But several groups have expressed doubts.
Very fitting na gamitin yung tumindi kasi diba yung symbol ng fist. Ginagamit siya ng mga activist para patampokin yung mga iba't ibang issues.
The Philippine National Police plans to deploy around 8,000 cops to activities in Metro Manila and Cebu on February 25th. It has yet to monitor security threats. PNP Chief General Benjamin Acorda Jr. had said that police will implement maximum tolerance but also appealed to protesters to hold their activities in a peaceful and orderly manner.
For the leader of the opposition party, the Liberal Party, the EDSA People Power Revolution is an enduring legacy which Filipinos must cherish and defend against historical revisionism. For more on this, we are joined by LP President and Albay Representative Edsel Lagman. Congressman Lagman, magandang hapon po. Thank you for joining us.
Magandang hapon.
All right, Congressman, let's start first with our plans for the People Power anniversary. Do you have anything going on today and tomorrow?
Well, there are so many activities still programmed and scheduled for today and tomorrow. And we hope that many would still attend the same activities. Mm-hmm. And it's including a concert. And we feel very strongly that the people responded to the call to celebrate the 38th anniversary of EDSA People's Power Revolution mm-hmm. by attending the mass yesterday at the EDSA Shrine. Mm-hmm. That was a clear manifestation that we have not forgotten And we will always remember this the historic event which toppled a dictator.
You mentioned, Congressman Edsel, that there will be a concert and a program. When will this be? Is this for tonight or for tomorrow? And where will this happen as well?
It will be for tomorrow. And actually, the celebration is still nationwide. Mm-hmm. In all places in the Philippines, there will be a commemoration of the 38th anniversary.
Mm-hmm. I just want to know, Congressman, because throughout the years, we've seen the celebration and the commemoration for the 1986 EDSA Revolution decreasing in those who would in attendees. How do you think what do you think we should do to be able to spread not just awareness on this, but, you know, for people to love the country and the democracy that we have right now?
Well, actually, the greatest challenge in dealing with the past is the struggle of memory against forgetting. That's why we have underscored 4 points with respect to the celebration of the EDSA People's Power Revolution. First, it was not an spontaneous uprising due to a brilliant spark of a moment. It was the culmination of an emboldening effort, sacrifices of Filipino patriots who opposed for 14 long years the imposition of martial law and the results of martial law on repression, profligacy, and oppression. Number two, it was not a revolution led by the elite. It was a peaceful uprising of a revolution of the masses and the middle class who fought for democracy and freedom to be regained. Number three, it was not a force of art, but a peaceful revolution impelled by a great determination to regain freedom and democracy. And number four, it is an enduring legacy that we should cherish, defend, and protect against the malevolence of historical distortionism and revision, and also against the importuning of those who would like to repeat such an era of cruelty and repression. It's the darkest period in Philippine history, which should never be allowed to again besiege the country and the Philippines.
Just like how it is for a legacy to always be remembered, the fight for the 1986 democracy is being challenged now by the newest movement for charter change. What's the stand of the Liberal Party on this issue, Congressman?
We have always been against charter change by any mode, because it is not necessary and it is not opportune. It is not necessary because these economic provisions in the Constitution are there to protect the Philippine posterity. We have declared in our Constitution that we should develop an economy effectively controlled by Filipinos against the dominance of foreigners. This move would be against such declaration. And moreover, it is not the Constitution which is defective. It are the defects are in the policies of the government and the neglect we are indulging. Like, for example, the ease of doing business, the necessity of having less corrupt official corruption should be eliminated or at least minimized. Mm-hmm. There should be better infrastructure support for investors. There should be certainty in our policies so that investors will be aware of what is going to happen and what will be implemented at the time they invest and during their operation. And then there should be also better internet speed and less cost of electricity or power. Mm-hmm. These are the prescriptions to induce foreign investment, not the liberalization of economic provisions, which would give undue dominance and ownership of basic utilities and sensitive enterprises. Mm-hmm.
All those things you mentioned, Congressman, are also things that political analysts are saying that actually don't need any legislative, changes. But thank you for that. Let's move on to another topic, as I only have limited time with you. Former Vice President Leni Robredo is mum on her political plans. We all know that. But I do know also, and reports are saying, that the Liberal Party is urging her to run for the senatorial slate. Any news on this, Congressman?
Well, as far as the senatorial slate is concerned, the Liberal Party is still finalizing this slate. Mm-hmm. There are many probables, and at the opportune time, we will be announcing our candidates. But we are still in the process of making a very thorough selection of credible, selfless, mm-hmm. and service-oriented candidates. Mm-hmm. We are assuring the public that we will have a strong, credible team for the senatorial elections in 2025. Mm-hmm. But at the moment, please just wait until we make a final announcement.
Okay, so for now, Congressman Edsel, there's no confirmation yet on whether or not you're courting former Vice President Leni Robredo to run for the opposition slate.
Well, we are in the process mm-hmm. of still talking to her mm-hmm. if lead the senatorial slate. But that is a decision which Leni would make. Mm-hmm.
All right. Final questions, final few, Congressman Edsel. For now, you mentioned that you're still finalizing who the candidates will be for the opposition slate, but what are the qualities you're looking for in a possible senatorial candidate?
Well, in the first place, we should have the qualities opposed to the present administration's officials and possible aspirants. Mm-hmm. In other words, we are looking for intelligent, proactive, sincere, and credible candidates. And we have many probables for inclusion in our list. Mm-hmm.
Right now, Liberal Party spokesperson former Senator Laila De Lima says there are three names that have already been fielded for the senatorial slate. Former Senator Bam Aquino, former Senator Kiko Pangilinan, and Attorney Chel Jocno. Are there more we're already just waiting for confirmation?
I would like to say that Laila De Lima, mm-hmm. our spokesperson, was quoted out of context. Uh-huh. She did not say that they are already included. Uh-huh. She did say that we have already at least three in our slate, mm-hmm. but just mentioned that they are probable mm-hmm. candidates to be included in our slate.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for clarifying that and also for your time, Congressman Edsel. It's a weekend, but you're here with us. Thank you for your afternoon and may you have a good weekend ahead of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sabrina, for this opportunity.
My pleasure. Congressman Edsel Lagma, the President of the Liberal Party of the Philippines.